Welcome to Jerry Boatner Field, the campus of West Lauderdale High School, where tonight the West Lauderdale Knights will take on Choctaw Central in a district contest. The Knights will come into the game with a record of 10-3 and 2-0 in district. While Choctaw Central comes in 1-7-1 and 0-2 in district. While we were away, West Lauderdale had several games. One, they played Brandon, lost by a score of 4-5. Then they took on Northeast Jones, and in that game, Jacob Wood went 2-for-4, scored 3 runs. Cannon Graham was 2-for-4 with 2 RBIs. Caden Boswood, his first hit a home run in the game, and Lees Jenkins was 3-for-4. Carter Horton got the win on the mound, going 3 innings, giving up 3 hits, no earned runs, and 3 Ks. The Knights then played Neshoba Central, won that by a score of 6-2. Ridge Brown was your winning pitcher, going 4.2 innings, 3 hits, no earned runs, 4 Ks. Cannon Graham had another good night, going 2-for-4, hitting a home run, and Jacob Wooten hitting his first home run of the year, going 1-3. So the Knights have won 2 in a row, lost 1 since we last were with you, lost to Brandon 4-5. So the Knights hope to continue their winning streak in district right here against Choctaw County. So we'll go through the starting lineups. First, for the homestanding Knights, Jacob Wooten will lead off and play shortstop. Owen Shirley will hit in the 2-hole and get the catching duties. Cannon Graham will play second base and hit third. Lees Jenkins will be a cleanup hitter and hit fourth, play first base. Carson Smith will be a designated hitter and hit fifth. Hunter Russell will hit sixth and play left field. Caden Peoples will hit seventh, play center field. Cody Pickford will be 8-hole hitter and play right field. And Carter Horton will be a third baseman and hit ninth. Caden Boswell will get the nod on the hill. For the visiting Choctaw Central Warriors, they'll lead off with Tristan Henry, the shortstop. And in the 2-hole, Alex Thompson playing third base. Jacob Isaac will be the catcher and hitting 3-hole. In the cleanup here, he'll be Adarius Lewis playing first base. Cooper Wesley will play right field and hit fifth. Keith and Anderson will be a designated hitter and hit sixth, and Adrian Fraser will be a center fielder and hit seventh. Avon Joe will be a left fielder in the 8-hole, and rounding out the order for Choctaw Central will be Hayden Willis playing second base. A.J. Lewis will be on the hill and pitch for the Warriors.
Good afternoon, baseball fans, and welcome to the campus of West Lauderdale High School and Jerry Boatner Field. This afternoon's contest features the visiting Choctaw Central Warriors and the West Lauderdale Knights. The Warriors are led by head coach Todd York, and now your starting lineup and batting order for the Choctaw Central Warriors. Starting at shortstop, number 21, Tristan Henry at third base, number 8, Alex Thompson. The catcher will be number 41, Jacob Isaac. At first base, number 53, Adarius Lewis. In right field, number 5, Cooper Wesley. The DH will be number 10, Keithan Anderson. In center field, number 6, Adrian Frazier. In left field, number 2, Aiden Joe. In second base, number 3, Hayden Willis. And on the mound pitching for the Warriors, number 7, A.J. Lewis. The Warriors are led by head coach Todd York, assisted by Kendall Steed and Adam Johnson. The Knights coming to tonight's game with a 10-3 record are led by head coach Jason Smith. And now your starting lineup and batting order for the West Lauderdale Knights. Starting at shortstop, number 25, Jacob Woodman. The catcher, number 13, Owen Shirley. The second base, number 5, Kenny Graham. The first base, number 3, Lee Jenkins. The DH, number 26, Carson Smith. In left field, number 1, Hunter Russell. In center field, number 22, Kaden Beeple. In right field, number 6, Cody Pickford. In third base, number 11, Carter Horton. And on the mound for the night, number 21, Kaden Boswell. The Knights are led by head coach Jason Smith, assisted by Jeremy Hurst, Dustin Hammer, and Cameron Partridge. And now, if you would please stand and remove your hat for the playing of for the invocation and the playing of the national anthem. Our Father in heaven, we thank you, Lord, for this day and this time that we have as a recreational sport of baseball. We ask you, Lord, to go with each player tonight, go with each parent and each coach as we go home following the game. We ask, Lord, that you give us grace and mercy, for we ask all this in your precious name. Amen.
So Kaden Boswell take the hill tonight for the Knights. Kaden comes in with a 4-1 record, pitched 22.2 innings on the year, giving up 7 earned runs, only walked 9 hitters and struck out 31. So he's got a good strikeout to walk ratio. His ERA is 2.162. Left a lot of guys on base, so he's pitched effectively when he's got guys and left them on base. So 16 left on base for Kaden. Batting average against him is 175, which is strong. So as I mentioned before, this is another district contest. The Knights took 2 from League Central last time we were with you. 2 easy games against League Central. This one, the Knights should handle these 2 games, but Choctaw Central is going to be a better club than League Central was. So I think this game will be a little bit more competitive. Choctaw's 0-2 in district. Knights are 2-0, so the Knights want to definitely come out of here with both these victories, go to 4-0. I think Newton County is going to be the big matchup for the Knights in district, and Northeast, of course, is always a big matchup. So It'd be nice to have those two teams left before we get to the playoffs. Nice and started out well. Got a good season going, 10-3. Played a lot of tough competition on their way here. They played Madison Central. Madison Central handled West pretty easily, scored 10-0. But then the Knights go to Brandon, play Brandon, and come away with a 2-1 win. Fantastic win. Beat Ocean Springs, both much bigger schools. Then the Knights turn around and got beat by Brandon over at Enterprise over spring break, but still a close game, 4-5. First pitch delivered from Boz, an outside corner for a strike. The Knights then took a win from Northeast Jones and a win against Neshoba Central. And so they're playing well right now, starting to get it together, middle of the season, ball outside. He was a count 1-1. Leading off for Choctaw Central is Tristan Henry, the shortstop. Good inside. Breaking pitch inside. Count moves to 2-1. Ball up, 3-1. So Caden falls behind the first hitter, 3-1, leadoff hitter. As a pitcher, you want to get that first strike over, first hitter out. There he runs the count to full, 3-2, a fastball in the outside corner. Good location from Boswell. And strike three, so Caden comes back and gets him. Finds the strike zone the last two pitches and indeed retires that first man out in the inning. That's important. Knight's goal is to get the first pitch over, first man out, shorten the inning. Alex Thompson, the third baseman, will come up for the Warriors. Fastball at the knees, outside half. Boswell with a fastball to Plunks. Thompson right in the back, so he'll take the free pass to first, the hard way. And that'll bring up Jacob Isaac, the catcher.
Your next batter is the catcher, number 41, Jacob Isaac.
Ball low, just below the knees and just off the outside. Count moves to 1-0. Boswell's pitched 22 innings this year. Walked 9 guys, so he doesn't walk a lot of hitters. There's a good breaking pitch center cut. Caden's an MCC signee, gonna follow his brother Cole there. Cole Boswell's moved on to play at USM. He's been doing well for the Golden Eagles down there in Hattiesburg. Another strike, breaking pitch, center cut, swung on and missed by Isaac. So now we got a 1-2 count, one out. Choctaw the runner at first. Little looping line drive. Going to be fielded by Wooten at short, so Wooten will record the out. Quick toss to first, but nothing going over there. Thompson got back in plenty of time. That'll bring up Adarius Lewis, first baseman.
With two outs, first baseman number 53, Adarius Lewis.
Breaking pitch from Boswell, fouled off. Fastball at the knees, good location from Caden. Count quickly 0-2. See if Caden maybe tries to just elevate a fastball right here and see if he can just pump it past him. Good fastball, but in. Down and in. Moves the count to 1-2. Breaking pitch hit down the right field line, but foul. Lewis got a good barrel on that, just pushed it down the right field line, just outside the in foul territory. So my guess is, after seeing that, Boswell will certainly come back with the fastball here. Couldn't quite time up the breaking pitch from Caden, but he was behind it. There's the fastball, and again fouled off the right-hand side, and yeah, he definitely a little bit behind that. There's a good one. Good breaking pitch down and away from Caden. And that'll finish the Warriors in the top half of the first. No runs on no hits. The Knights come into the plate. Choctaw scored zero. Knights coming up.
For the Warriors, there were no runs on no hits, no errors, and one man left on base. Two up for the Knights, Jacob Wooten, Owen Sheridan, and Cannon Graham. Baseball for the night game provided by Chris McDonald, your local State Farm agent. The leadoff of the Knights, the second, the shortstop, number 25, Jacob Wooten.
So it'll be Wooten, Shirley, and Graham, top half of the first. Wooten comes in hitting 359. Three doubles, one home run, four RBIs, 14 runs scored. So Wooten is kind of the trigger man. He gets on base, he scores most of the time. Good cut from Wooten, foul straight back. Count moves to 0-1. A.J. Lewis is your pitcher for Choctaw Central. On the dirt, evens it up 1-1. Yeah, as you would expect, Wooten, Graham, and Jenkins are your biggest run scorers at this point in the season, and they're at the top of the order. So you would expect that over the top half. There's a little dinker over shortstop's head. That's going to be in for a single. Like Wooten may have got, Jacob might have got that one just off the end of the bat. But nonetheless, a little dying quail out there in left field. And Wooten reaches first, and that'll bring up Owen Shirley.
You next run is catcher number 13, Owen Shirley.
Shirley's hitting 226. Getting on base at 415 click, so he's in the two hole hitting 226, but he's getting on base a lot, which is important. Shirley takes a strike. Wooten takes second. Kind of an awkward slide. Jacob kind of got his hand stuck in the dirt right there. Rolled over. He's okay. Hopped up. So Owen's got a runner in scoring position. There's a bullet. Good, solid single from Shirley to put runners on the corners. The Knights have something going here in the top half of the first, and that'll bring Cannon Graham to the plate. Graham's hitting 310, 11 RBIs, 13 runs scored. Cooper Rainer would be a courtesy runner for Shirley, the catcher. So Knights threatening early against Choctaw Central. Pick to first. Rainer back in plenty of time. So Choctaw Central's played West Lauderdale enough to know that they'll run on first and third situations to see if they can make something happen. And there it is. There's the throw down to second, and sure enough, Wooten walks in, scores easily. Catcher almost looked like he was throwing that back to the pitcher. Pitcher chose not to catch it. Looks over and pats his chest to the coach, thinking that maybe he might have missed that. Maybe he was supposed to catch that as a snap throw to see if he could throw behind Wooten at third. But instead, the Knights push across the first run of the night and now lead 1-0. One oh count on Graham. Ball outside, 2-0. Center fielder, outfield playing relatively shallow for Cannon. If Cannon gets into one, they're gonna run it down. It'll be 2-1. Ball outside, 3-1. So now if you're Graham, you're sitting dead red right here, 3-1 count. Gonna come right down what he could. Pitch wasn't competitive, Cannon didn't offer at it, so he'll take the free pass to first. Knights have two guys on for Lees Jenkins. Lees Jenkins off to a hot start beginning of the season in 469. 15 hits, 6 doubles, 2 home runs, 10 RBIs, 13 runs scored. So Lees has been a catalyst for the offense. Him and Cannon lead the team. Lees Jenkins, Carson Smith, Cannon Graham, Lees and Jenkins and Smith have 10 RBIs. Graham has 11. So those are your run, the people driving in the runs for the Knights right now. There's a line drive out in the gap. It's going to get down. Going to bounce and roll up against the Parker Marketing sign out in left center. They're going to hold Leeds up, and he'll add to his double count. A two-run double from Jenkins. That'll be his 7th double of the year and 12th RBI, 11 and 12 RBI. So Leeds gets the job done.
Yeah. The batter's the DH, number 26, Carson Smith.
Carson Smith comes in hitting 371. Two doubles, 10 RBIs, six runs scored. Jenkins has got good wheels at first. I mean, at second. Carson hits a drive out to center. Center fielder range is over. It's over his head. Don't know if he lost it the high sky in the, this time of night, but looks like he just did not pick that one up at all. What should have been an easy play for the center fielder was never touched. Carson Smith will take it. Run scoring double will push the Knights' lead out to four here in the bottom of the first.
Here at the left fielder, number one,
Hunter Russell will come to the plate in 314. Two doubles, nine RBIs. Swing and a miss and an outside fastball. Russell down on the count 0-1. Nice and plated four in the bottom of the first. Four runs on four hits. To Choctaw's no runs on no hits. Ball low. Now moves to 1-1. Ball low again. Count moves to 2-1. Breaking pitch popped up on the infield. First baseman reins is over, makes the play. And so Choctaw Central records the first out of the bottom half of the first. And that'll bring up Caden Peoples. Caden hitting 333. Four RBIs, three runs scored.
The next batter with one out is center fielder number 22, Caden Peoples.
Ball low, 1-0. Knights have played four in the bottom of the first. Lead 4-0. Good job by Caden keeping his hands back, foul that breaking pitch off. He looked pretty good seeing that breaking pitch. Just got under it a little bit. It's just off the plate, but he's had a good stride, kept his hands back, waited for it to get there, and then took a good cut at it. Just didn't quite center it up. It's a good eye. Ball in the dirt. Moves the count to 2-1. High fastball. Caden swings at and misses. Kind of undecided cut right there from Caden. Two count. One out in the inning. Ball low. Good eye. Runs the count full. So Caden's worked the count full. Nice lead, 4-0. They have four runs on four hits in the bottom of the first. That's ball up. So, Peoples has a good at bat. Coaches a walk out of Lewis. And the Knights have runners on first and second with one out. And that'll bring up Cody Pickford. Pickford in 235 in the season. Two RBIs, two runs scored. He has walked seven times, leads the team in walks. Good cut from Pickford, fouled straight back. Count moves to 0-1, Knights have runners on first and second. Still one out in the inning. Pickford's hitting in the eight hole, so Carter Horton will be on deck, and then he'll be back to the top of the order. Ball low, counts 1-1. Look for Coach Smith to pull too many tricks. Already got been spotted to a 4-0 lead. Ball inside 2-1. Pickford just ducked under it. Swing and a miss. Fastball a hair bit high. Pickford just couldn't lay off of it. Count moves to 2-2. Swing and a miss. And so Lewis get the second out of the inning via the strikeout. And that'll bring up Carter Horton. So Carter's hitting 200 on the year.
The two outs, about his third baseman, number 11, Carter Horton.
Got one double, one triple, four RBIs, scored a run. The fly ball down the first base line. First baseman ranges over, can't make the play in foul territory, so Carter will retreat back to home plate. Down 0-1. There's a little looper right to the second baseman. Carter just got it off the end of the bat. Just didn't quite get enough sting on it. So the Knights are retired in the bottom half of the first inning, but they played four and take a 4-0 lead into the top of the second. So, due up for the Warriors in the top half of the second. It's going to be Cooper Wesley, Keith and Anderson, and Adrian Frazier coming into play. Wesley will lead off the right fielder.
Due up for the Warriors, the right fielder, number 5, Cooper Wesley.
Came a little bit low in the zone. Count moves to 1-0. Good fastball from Boswell up. Low 83 mile an hour fastball at the top of the zone. Fouled off to right hand side. Count evens up 1-1. Ooh, that's a really, really good 12-6 breaking ball from Boswell. That had a lot of bite on it. Fouled off into the catcher's mitt. Count moves to 1-2, but that's the best breaking ball I've seen Caden throw this year, and it was a 12-6er, and that was impressive. Another breaking pitch up in the zone, 2-2. He stays on top of that breaking ball. That'll be a tough pitch to hit. Fastball gets him to chase it. So one out via the strikeout. That'll bring up Keith and Anderson, designated hitter for Choctaw Central. Caden again gets ahead 0-1 on a fastball at the top of the zone. Another fastball, 0-2, so quickly ahead. Boswell's working ahead in this inning, which is good to see. Fastball, low and inside, 1-2. That's a pretty good pitch from Caden. Doesn't want to give him anything in the center of the plate, but just enough down and in. Maybe he tries to take a cut and do something with that and gets a strikeout or a weak ground ball. Not a bad miss. There's a breaking pitch. Fouled off. 1-2. See if Caden tries to throw a fastball here, maybe somewhere off the plate on the outside half. Okay, well, that was it. He didn't go, though. A little bit up and out of the zone. Caden ran back, tried to get a little extra. Count evens up 2-2. Knights lead 4-0. Top half of the second. There it is. That's the pitch he was looking for right there. So another strikeout recorded by Boswell. Fastball just on the black.
With two outs, the batter to center field, their number 6, Adrian Frazier.
So Adrian Frazier come to the plate, the center fielder. Ball up, 1-0. Breaking pitch down in the zone, 2-0. Caden took a lot off of that one. That more had more of a sideways break than an overhand break. Ball up, 3-0. So Boswell quickly behind 3-0. Ball inside, so walks him on 4 straight pitches.
Left fielder, number 2, Avon Joe.
So Avon Joe, left fielder, come up for the Warriors. Warriors now have a man on first, trailing 4-0. Knights have 4 runs on 4 hits in the bottom half of the first. There's a good pitch from Caden. He covers nicely right there, pumps a fastball across the inside part of the plate. Good fastball up, quickly 0-2. Good fastball, center cut at the knees. Really nice pitch. Had a little bit of movement on it, too. Ball slid just a little bit away from that right-handed hitter. So, Boswell retires the side, gives up one walk. Knights carry a 4-0 lead in the bottom of the second.
That happened to the end for the Warriors. There were no runs, no hits, no errors. And one man left on base, still up to the Knights. Jacob Wooten, Owen Cherry, and Kenny Graham.
So due up for the Knights here in the bottom of the second inning will be the top of the order, Wooten, Shirley, and Graham. So Lewis returns for his second inning of work. Knights will have the top of the order up in the form of Wooten, Shirley, and Graham. Wooten 1-for-1, scored a run his last time up. A solid single to left field. Ball inside. Hard hit ball in the left field line, foul. Count evens up 1-1. Warriors have pulled the corners in. A little respect for Jacob's speed there, making sure he's not going to lay down a bunt. I do think, however, that if he would were to lay down a bunt and push it towards first, I believe he would beat it out. It's a breaking pitch inside, 2-1. Warriors are definitely playing Jacob either bunt and pull. They pulled the shortstop way over into the hole between short and third. Wooten hits a pop fly behind first base. Second baseman ranges over, looks to make the play, and he does. Nice play with the second baseman. And that'll retire Jacob. First out in the bottom of the second. That'll bring up Owen Shirley.
With one out, the batter's the captain, number 13, Owen Sheridan.
Shirley. Shirley, 1-for-1 on the night, singled last time up. Swing and a miss. Count moves to 0-1. Ball outside. Kennedy was up 1-1. Nicely 4-0. Bottom half of the second inning. Ball in the dirt again. Count 2-1. Again, count moves to 3-1. So Shirley's run the count to 3-1. It's probably looking dead red right here. And still, the Warriors have nothing covered up the middle. Up the middle is just a chasm up there. Anything hit remotely hard toward second base is going to get through. Ball outside. So Shirley will take first base via the free pass. We'll get Cooper Rayner as a courtesy runner. And Cannon Graham coming to the plate. Graham walked his last time up.
Courtesy runner for the catcher, number 35, Cooper Rayner.
Scored a run.
Your next runner is second baseman, number 5, Cannon Graham.
Now the shortstop moves over a little bit more into double play depth. Not quite double play depth, but he's at least closer to the bag, and he's in that way. Second baseman holds his position, thinking that Cannon is probably going to pull the ball. There's a wild throw down in the Choctaw Central bullpen. Cooper Rayner can fly, and he's going to end up here at third base. And now that puts the runner in scoring position. Cannon Graham, fly ball, base hit, number of ways to get Cooper Rayner home could occur here. Graham's a good contact hitter, doesn't strike out a whole lot, so any ground ball up the middle is going to score Rayner. Any fly ball on the outfield is going to score him. Ball inside, count moves to 1-0. It's amazing in baseball how one little mistake, like an overthrow at first, takes you from a very remote possibility of scoring from first base of one out to a likelihood that you will score standing at third. Count moves up, evens up 1-1, or breaking pitch over the outside corner at the top of the zone. Ball up 2-1. Cannon doing a good job of waiting out his pitch. I think he feels like that Lewis is not going to throw it past him, so he's waiting for something he thinks he can drive. Ball inside. Count moves to 3-1. Lee's Jenkins stands on deck. Lee's already hit a double tonight. 1-for-1, run score, 2 RBIs. So Jenkins is probably chomping at the bit to get up there one more time with a runner in scoring position. That's called a strike on the outside half. Not a pitch Graham wanted to swing at right there. Maybe a little bit off the plate. Nothing Cannon could do with that. So probably wise decision to hold off, run it to 3-2 and see what you get here. There's a high fastball, yanked foul out of play. might have been ball four, but I'm sure that looked like a beach ball coming in there to Cannon. He was just ready to jump all over something after seeing all those pitches, nothing he could really do anything with. Another foul ball. Graham does a good job fighting that off. Ball bottom of the strike zone. Maybe a little low. Too close to take, though. Ball low. So, get it back from Graham. Runners on the corners. Jenkins comes to the plate. Really know where to go with this if you're Choctaw Central coach. And when you walk Jenkins, you got Smith. So Smith's already driven in one RBI. Both he and Jenkins have doubled already in the game, so kind of pick your poison here if you're the coach of Choctaw Central. So Jenkins comes to the plate, one for one on the day, two RBIs are unscored. Got runners on the corners for the Knights. Cannon Graham stands at first. Cooper Rayner at third, courtesy runner for Owen Shirley. Ball in the dirt. Count moves to 1-0. Nice lead, 4-0, bottom half of the second. One out. Knights have 4 runs on 4 hits at this point in the game. Choctaw Central, no runs on no hits. Knights would love to tack on a few more here. Put some distance between them and Choctaw. Graham easing his lead out further and further. And there he goes. Oh, hit and deflected by the pitcher. I think that was the exact same play they miscued on a second ago. At the time the pitcher didn't catch it, but at least he tipped it, kept the runner from going home. But now both runners are in scoring position. Counts at 1-1. One out. Ball outside, 2-1. Anything in the zone right here, and I believe Leeds just jumps all over it. Swing and a miss. Got to give Lewis credit. That's the best breaking pitch he's thrown all night. He started that at Leeds' waist, and the bottom fell out of it right at the plate. Jenkins swing just over the top of it. To give Lewis, you just tip your hat to him right there. It's a good pitch. See if Jenkins can... two-strike mode. It's a foul ball. Hit off to the right side. I believe it's going to get out of play, and it does. So now Leeds is going to be in protection mode a little bit. Two balls, two strikes. One out. Leeds is going to choke up just a hair and see if he can put that ball in play and get that runner at third home. Again, Choctaw Central opens up the middle of the field. Any kind of ground ball that's sitting near second is going to easily get through. There's a fly ball out the left field. I believe Cooper Rayner is going to tag, even though it's really shallow. He does. Here comes the throw. And it gets past the catcher. Rayner's going to score. Runner's going to move up 90 feet. Graham's going to be a third. So the Knights plate that fifth run of the inning. On a sacrifice fly from Leeds Jenkins. So Jenkins does his job, gets a run home. Heads up base running by Graham to get to third base on that tag play. I believe Coach Smith is having a conversation with the catcher about the catcher's position on that ball, blocking the plate, blocking the line. I believe Coach Smith got an explanation he could live with. Go back to third. Third base. See if we can get Graham home. So Carson Smith comes to the plate. Carson Smith one for one, one RBI. Doubled his last time up. I think he hit it over center fielder's head, if I remember right. Ball outside, 1-0. Drive by Smith down the left field line. Ball's going to fall just foul outside the foul line. So Carson tried to almost dropped it in a perfect place. But he'll come back and do it again. 1-1 count, two outs. Knights lead 5-0. Knights have 5 runs on 4 hits. Choctaw Central, no runs on no hits. Foul ball. Smith just swung over the top of it, just nicked it back against the backstop. So now it's a 1-2 count. Ball inside, evens it up 2-2. Hunter Russell waits on deck. Ball up 3-2. So 3-2 count, two outs. There's a good swing by Smith. A bullet line drive into right field is going to play Graham. So Carson Smith comes through, drives in that 6th run of the night for the Knights. Smith has himself a good night, going 2-for-2, 2 RBIs.
The batter to left fielder number 1, Hunter Russell.
That'll bring Hunter Russell to the plate. Russell 0-for-1 so far tonight. Carson's got pretty good wheels at first. 6-0. If Coach Smith wants to send him right here, but I'm betting within the first 3 pitches, Carson's gone. I think Choctaw Central probably feels the same way. So there's a pause in the action for some reason over in the Choctaw Central dugout. You can't really tell what's going on.
Parking lot, please set their lights on.
Headlights on the vehicle. So Hunter Russell at the plate. Smith at first, ball low, 1-0. Little flare down the right field line, just foul. Counts 1-1. There's a line drive right to the second baseman. Hard hit ball by Russell. Just tough luck right at the second baseman. Easy flip to shortstop to retire the Knights. But the Knights tack on two, and they'll carry a 6-0 lead in the top of the third.
That half of the inning for the Knights, there were 2 runs on 1 hit, no errors, and nobody left on base. Still up for the Warriors, Hayden Willis, Tristan Henry, and Alex Thompson. So
nicely 6-0, top of the third. Hayden Willis, second baseman.
Hayden Willis
will lead off the top half of the third for the Warriors. It'll be Willis, Henry, and Thompson. Henry and Thompson are the 1-2 hitters. Choctaw order. Basel with a pitch down, 1-0. Basel's thrown well. There's the strike center cut. At this point, he's pitched 2 innings. No runs, none. Only 1 base on balls and 5 strikeouts. So Caden's been around the plate, working in the zone. That ball was up and chased. That helps. So that count moves to 1-2. Knights have 6 runs on 5 hits. Choctaw Central, no runs on no hits. Good location from Boswell, just down and in. Count evens up 2-2. Boswell has issued 1 walk. Breaking pitch pushes the count to 4-3-2. There's strike three. Top of the zone, swing out and missed.
Your next batter is shortstop number 21, Tristan Henry.
Ball outside, 1-0. Swing and a miss. Count evens up 1-1. Strike center cut, 1-2, maybe right at the top of the zone. On Henry, the leadoff hitter for Chalk Dogs. Ball high, 2-2. Henry's got a rather small strike zone, not too tall. Kind of compacts everything, but Basel retires in the strikeout anyway. So, 2 quick outs, both via the strikeout. And Alex Thompson, the third baseman, will come to the plate.
Alex Thompson.
Thompson was hit by a pitch. He's 0-0 on the night. There's a strike center cut. I believe that's the one of only 2 base runners at this point in the game that Choctaw Central's had. fouled straight back. Count quickly 0-2. So Basel way out in front here on the count. Thompson chokes way up on the bat, looking for anything to hit contact. Fouls it straight back again, 0-2. That was a good pitch from Basel at the top of the zone. Thompson chased it and was just able to foul it off. That's when a lot of times players will swing through. And Thompson did a good job to get his bat on it. Same pitch, a little bit out of the zone there, not much to offer at. Basel did have a little bit better velocity there, 86. So his velocity's coming around. There's a good fastball just off the plate. Good location from Caden. Runs the count 2-2. Good breaking pitch. Shirley's going to have to throw it to first, and he does. And so the Warriors go 1-2-3. All via the strikeout. Nice secure section at the lead in the bottom of the third.
That had the inning for the Warriors. There were no runs, no hits, no errors, and nobody left on base. Give up for the Knights. Kenny Peoples, Cody Pickford, and Carter Horton. We'd like to remind you the second game of this two-game series between the Knights and the Warriors will take place at Choctaw Central Friday afternoon. Game times at 5 and 7. The leadoff of the Knights, the center fielder, number 22, Caden Peoples.
So Caden Peoples coming to the plate. Peoples walked his last time up. Ball in the dirt, 1-0. Knights lead 6-0, bottom of third. There's a drive out to left center. Center fielder range is over. And does not make the play. I believe he picked it up with his hand off the ground. Don't think he quite caught it. And indeed, Caden's going to have a double. We'll see what WL game changer scores that. That could go either way. The center fielder did have a little slide at the end. It looks like they're going to score it a double just because it did seem to be a little bit of an extra effort out there. But in this announcer's opinion, probably should have been caught. So that'll bring up Cody Pickford. Pickford 0 for 1, struck out his last time up. Ball outside, 1-1. Pickford swings through that one, 1-2. Ball low and away. Count moves to 2-2. Good job by the Choctaw catcher, Jacob Isaac. Good job snaring that ball for into the backstop, or else Knights have a runner at third. Ball at the top of the zone. Count runs full, 3-2. So 3-2 count. Pickford's looking for something, knowing the pitcher doesn't want to walk him. He should be looking for something in the center of the plate. Just something he can drive. And that's a ball low. Going to get past the catcher. Pickford will take the free pass to first. And Peoples advance on the pass ball to third. That's one probably the Choctaw catcher should have handled with a little bit of ease. Went off the end of his glove, rolled back. Gives the Knights an extra base. Bring up Carter Horton. Horton 0 for 1.
Your next batter is the third baseman, number 11, Carter Horton.
Ball up, breaking pitch, 1-0. The Knights would like to play several runs in this inning to get it to where they're able to reach the run rule here in the next inning or two. Ball low, 2-0. So runners on second and third. Nobody out. Knights lead 6-0. Six runs on six hits to this point in the game. Doubles by Smith, Peoples, and Jenkins. Horton swings and misses at a slow breaking pitch, almost like Carter was way out ahead of it, tried to stop himself and just finished the swing. So one more Carter just wants to work up the middle. Ball up, 3-1. Pitcher's not going to throw it past you. Just work up the middle. Try to work up the middle, see if he can poke something through the hole. Ball up. And Horton will get the free pass. Warriors have activity in their bullpen. Can't see the players' numbers. But they are throwing. And that'll flip the order over to Jacob Wooten. The base is loaded, nobody out.
Number 25.
Wooten's 1-for-2 on the night, scored a run. Catcher wants to have a word with his pitcher. So for Choctaw Central, this is not where you want to be. Bases loaded in the top of the ninth order. Most of the damage from the Knights comes in that 1-5 hole hitters. Wooten takes one in the dirt, 1-0. Jacob with the drive out to left field. Left fielder's not going to get it. It's going to go up against the wall. Pickford runs right through a stop sign that holds up as Coach Smith probably yells at him. So a long single for Jacob. He smoked that, but the third, but Caden pretty much had to stay at third. The left fielder looked like he was going to have a play on that ball. It just got over his head, kicked off against the wall, and then Caden was able to take off. Otherwise, you know, several runs score, but that's the situation. Caden couldn't help make sure the ball hits the ground, score the run. Bases still loaded for the Knights. Still an opportunity to do some damage here with nobody out in the 7-0 lead. Shirley takes one in the dirt, gets away from the catcher, but not far enough that Pitford can score. Ball in the dirt, 2-0. So Shirley right here has got to look dead red, something center of the plate. He's going to get a good pitch. Opportunity to drive in a couple more. There it is. Shirley just gets under it. It's a towering fly ball out to center field. Center fielder coming in, makes the play. Here comes the tag. Tag goes to the cutoff man. And Shirley does his job. Sacrifice fly. Gets the 8th run home of the game. Carter Horton tags and advances to third. Cannon Graham will come to the plate.
The next batter is the second baseman, number 5.
With an opportunity to add another. Knights lead 8-0. They have 8 runs on 7 hits. Wooten takes off, takes second, uncontested. So now the Knights have the potential run rule. In effect, run, stand at second base with one out. And Jacob Wooten will score on a single from Graham. Ball low, away, 2-0. Barring something crazy happening, anything hitting the outfield, Jacob's got the wheels to get home. Swing and a miss right over the top by Cannon. Counts 2-1. There's a line drive, just foul. Down in the right field corner. Now it's 2-2. Still one out in the inning. Knights have plated 4 in the first, 2 in the second, 2 in the third. 8 runs on 7 hits. The Choctaws, no runs on no hits. There's another one. Same spot, pulled a little bit further left. Excuse me, right. So 2-2 count. There's a fly ball out to right field. Right fielder's going to range over. Can't make the play. That's going to score both runs. Graham runs right through a stop sign. He's going to end up at third. So Graham with a solid lick out to right field. Couldn't tell if the right fielder touched it, if he misplayed it. Don't know what happened. But needless to say, Graham pushed across, runs 9 and 10. So the Warriors are going to make a pitching change. Looks like Chance Briscoe would take over the mound duties for Choctaw Central. So A.J. Lewis will exit the game, going 2 1/3 innings with 8 hits, 10 runs, all of which are earned, 6 base on balls, 1 strikeout, and he'll still be responsible for the runner at third base. And Lee's Jenkins coming to the plate.
On the mound for the Warriors, 00 Chance Briscoe.
So Chance Briscoe will indeed take over the pitcher duties for the Warriors. That'll bring Leeds Jenkins to the plate. Jenkins, 1-for-1 on the nice quarter run, 3 RBIs.
Number 3, Leeds Jenkins.
Cannon Graham stands at third. Nice lead, 10-0 on 8 hits. Choctaw Central, no runs on no hits. Neither team has scored with an error yet. Good pitch by Briscoe. Good breaking pitch. Another breaking pitch. This time plunks Jenkins right in the back. So Leeds will take the free pass to first. And that'll bring up Carson Smith. Carson Smith's 2-for-2, 2 RBIs, a double.
Your next runner is DH number 26, Carson Smith.
Smith fouls it off left hand side. Count moves to 0-1. There's a drive by Smith out into right field. Right fielder is under it, makes the play. But that will get Graham home. So Smith does his job. Sacrifice fly scores Cannon. Nice take, 11-0 lead. That'll bring home Russell to the plate. Russell 0 for 2.
That is left fielder number 1, Hunter Russell.
There's a ground ball hit right. Second baseman makes a good play. I don't think he's going to throw him out. He can't. Wild throw moves the runner to third. Well-placed single by Hunter Russell. I'm going to say that's going to be scored a hit. That would have been a tough play even if he did make a good throw. So now you got Jenkins at third, Russell at first. Caden Peoples coming to the plate. Peoples 1-for-1. Walked one time, scored a run. He's got a double already tonight. Knights lead 11-0. Breaking pitch up and in, 1-0. I don't see Coach Smith sending Russell from first. This Russell just takes it on his own. There's no point really in this. That's going to get the 12th run home. Jenkins will come home on the wild pitch. Russell will advance to second. Make the score 12-0 Knights. Peoples quickly ahead in the count 2-0. Shortstop. Shortstop makes a good diving stop, but can't throw out KP. The Knights will end up with runners on the corners.
Next batter, right fielder number 6, Toby Pickford.
Cody Pickford coming to the plate. Pickford's 0-for-1. Walked. Scored a run. It's a good breaking pitch from Briscoe. Gets ahead of the count 0-1. Again, I don't see Coach Smith giving Caden the steal sign at first. Ball inside, 1-1. Mm-hmm. All inside, 2-1. So Pickford at the plate. 0-1, one run scored, walked. Pickford hits the drive out in the left field. Left fielder ranges over and makes the play. Well hit ball by Pickford to give the left fielder Avon Joe some credit. He ran it down. But the Knights played six and carry a 12-0 lead in the top of the fourth.
And that happened then to the Knights. There were six runs on five hits, no errors, and one man left on base. Due up for the Warriors, Jacob Isaac, Darius Lewis, and Cooper Wesley. On the mound for the Knights, number 22, Caden Peoples.
So Caden Peoples gets some duty on the mound. He'll take over for Boswell. People has a high fastball. Count moves to 1-0. The Warriors will have Isaac, Lewis, and Wesley at the plate. Fastball inside, 2-0. Ground ball at the Wooten. Wooten fields it cleanly, throws the first, and in time. So good job by Wooten on the ground ball. One quick out for Peoples in the top of the fourth. Swing and a miss. Count moves to 0-1. I was looking up people's stats. He's pitched one inning to this point in the season. Of course, Caden got a late start. He played basketball. Knights had a good run in the playoffs. So Caden was playing basketball, so he hadn't really had a chance to get in good pitching shape. So he's pitched one inning, struck out all three batters he faced to this point in the season. They're probably, coaching staff is probably looking to work Caden in bit by bit, just to get him game experience here and there. There's a swing on a strike three. Wild pitch goes back to the screen. and the Warrior hitter will reach first base via the wild pitch. So still one out. Knight lead 12 to nothing here in the top of the fourth. That'll bring up Cooper Wesley.
So that is the right fielder, number five, Cooper Wesley.
Fastball poked into right field. And so the Warriors have their first hit of the evening as Lewis breaks up the no-hitter.
Next batter is DH number 10, Keithan Anderson.
That'll bring up Keithan Anderson. Ball up. Anderson 0 for 1, strikeout victim his last time up. Ground ball again to second. Graham ranges over, throws the first for one. Back to two, not in time. Jenkins does a good job of keeping that ball in play, not letting it get back into the into the Warrior dugout, into that dead area. If you're looking at the Warrior dugout, all that area to the left is a potential dead ball, and if that would have happened, that would have caused the runner at third to come home. So good job by Jenkins to keep that wild throw from happening. So the Knights have two outs, still lead 12 to nothing. Knights have 12 runs on 10 hits to this point in the game. Warriors, no runs on one hit. And now have runners at the corners. Peoples fires a fastball high.
The batter is the center fielder, number 6, Adrian Frazier.
Okay, he's got good velocity, low 80s. A little bit low there. Count moves to 2-0. Looks just a little bit quick on the mound. There's a good delivery into the zone. Slowed down a little bit. Wasn't so quick with his upper body there. Kind of kept everything closed and then kind of unleashed it. Good, one of his better pitches right there at the top of the zone. Ball up. Count moves to 3-1. Runner goes from first. Knights will let him have it. Counts 3-2. And ball four. So the bases are loaded. That'll bring up Avon Joe. Joe 0 for 1. Strikeout victim his last time up. Bases full of Warriors. Knights lead 12 to nothing.
Left fielder number 2, Avon Joe.
That center cut at the knees. Good pitch from Peoples right there. Count moves to 0-1. Two outs. Another good location. Same spot. 0-2. So Caden's made an adjustment. It's gone from up in the zone to now around the knees, which is really where you'd want to, where you want to live at. There's that same at the knee location. Out to center field, Zayden Moore, who I missed entering the game, and I apologize for that. Zayden Moore's got center field duties, ranges over and records that third out of the inning. So the Knights take a 12-0 lead.
Will take place in Choctaw Central Friday.
And it is 12 runs after 4 is a run rule victory. So the West Lauderdale Knights will take their third district victory this season by a score 12-0 over the Choctaw Central Warriors. So the Knights will travel up to, next game will be at Choctaw Central Friday, March 22nd at 7 p.m. If you can make the trip, head up there and support the Knights. So we'll go through a little bit of the highlights of the game tonight. On the mound for the Knights, Caden Boswell was outstanding. Three innings pitched, only one walk, struck out eight. He'll record the win. Caden came in, got that last inning, gave up one hit, walked one, struck out one. Leading hitter for the night, Jacob Wooten was 2-for-3. Carson Smith, 2-for-2. Caden Peoples, 2-for-2. Doubles by Smith, Peoples, and Jenkins. Graham had a triple. So overall, a pretty good night all the way around. Knights only had one strikeout, walked six times, 10 RBIs, 10 hits. Knights really had a complete victory tonight over the Choctaw Central Warriors. So the Knights will stay undefeated in district, and we know they'll go up to Choctaw, play Friday, have to take that game. That's that, you know, just making sure you're staying on track. And then they're going to hit the stretch where they'll play Northeast, and then they'll play Newton County, and those will be the series that decide district for the most part, I believe. Especially that Newton County district at the end. But West has got to get past Choctaw Central, handle Northeast Lauderdale, which is never easy in a cross-county rivalry. So we'll see what happens. Now this weekend, let's see, Knights will go Friday to Choctaw Central. Saturday they'll be at home versus Northwest Rankin. Might want to come out for that game. That'll be an entertaining ball game. Northwest Rankin, a 7A school, coming here to play us. That'll be competitive, very competitive. Something the Knights need. We're in the middle of district play, where sometimes maybe the competition's not what you want it to be. You need to have those weekend games to kind of get your game ramped back up. But the next two district games will be that. Northeast and Newton County will be good ball games. So if you can this weekend, come out and see the Knights play Northwest Rankin at 2 p.m. at Jerry Boatner Field. Knights, run their record to 11-3 total, 2-0 in district with a 12-0 win over the Choctaw Central Warriors. This is Marcus Willis for West Lauderdale Baseball and West Lauderdale Athletics signing off. Have a great evening.